Again, along with our theme of the keynotes this morning, we're talking about accessibility, we're talking about user experience, considerations for consumers, and UX. So one of the great things that happened within the FIDO Alliance over the last couple years is we formed a UX working group. So when you introduce passkeys to whether it's a consumer or it's an employee, there's a real need for consistency around, okay, well, how do you explain passkeys? What kind of terminology do you use? What kind of graphics do you use? In what order do you use them? What kind of flow should you go with? When should you use prompts? Questions like this. This is, you can get the tech so far, but if you don't get users to opt in, then we're not really going to meet our mission, right? So our UX working group, it's an amazing group of UX leads and content leads from companies all over the world that are coming together to do just that, to do research and inform the best practices for UX when it comes to passkeys and other FIDO authentication flows. So we are really lucky to have Mitch Galavan, who is the UX lead at Google, along with Court Morgan, who's the UX content lead at Google, here to talk to you about how Google has looked at doing these things that I have just talked about. So looking at the flows, the terminology, they've gone through many iterations. I think many of you know that Google's live on Google account, which is, you know, an amazing thing. So those flows that you see, Mitch and Court are they're responsible for that. And not only have Mitch and Court done this work for Google, they've also contributed a lot to the UX working group as well. So I think that they're ready. Is Mitch there? Okay, so they are ready. So please help me to welcome Mitch and Court.
Is there a clicker?
It's on the podium. Okay.
Hey everyone, it's really amazing to be here, and thank you so much for this opportunity to speak with you today. I'm here with my amazing colleague, Court, and we are going to talk with you about designing the passkey experience for Google.com. Let's see, are we clicking? We're clicking, beautiful. All right, so today, passwords are the default choice for authentication across the web. And we know this, we're familiar with this. At this conference, we're having all kinds of sophisticated conversations about moving to a passwordless future. But we always love to start with the ground level and what the user is experiencing, so we can remind ourselves exactly what we're changing and what we're helping people address. So passwords are what users are super familiar with. It's like a muscle memory. So it's often the go-to choice for securing accounts. But already, even today, before passwordless is the norm, we see that users recognize the value of biometrics, So things like fingerprint scan, facial recognition, PIN codes, SMS codes, all of these things people see as more valuable and useful and secure than passwords. And so, on top of that, there's some reasons that we, as Google, believe in passkeys. They offer a really simple UX through using screen locks and biometrics, and with that, they offer really great security. And so they offer this really great streamlined sign-in and account creation experience. So not only are they using really familiar biometrics that we're all used to on our phones, they can also make use of PIN locks, they can make use of anything like that, that users are already familiar with every day. And Google's in a really unique position. So we believe that passkeys are the next generation of authentication and can live alongside existing authentication factors. We're working really closely with the FIDO Alliance to make use of passkeys at scale, and we're really working hard to make sure it's a great experience for everybody. And one thing we've learned is that when we're introducing passkeys to users, we really want to find what holds value for your users. And I really want to emphasize your users. So for your app, product, or service, you have to find out what's most valuable to them and what resonates with them when introducing something like a new authentication method like passkeys. And so passkeys will benefit both you and your users. So encourage adoption by grounding passkeys in value that resonates with them, something meaningful to your user base. So for a bank, people might care most about keeping their accounts safe. And in online shopping, quick checkouts really might be the most important thing to that particular cohort. And so at Google, when we were trying to find our value and what resonated with users, we pulled on a lot of threads. And we'll walk you through one of those examples right now. So we thought it'd be really interesting to introduce Socks, your authentication buddy, for an experiment. And our whole idea here was to just turn authentication on its head and introduce something new. And we wanted Socks, as an experiment, to be your sign-in buddy, to be somebody who could guide you through authentication and help make passwordless or new authentication systems seem more friendly and easy to understand. And really, what we were trying to do was find a way to deal with the complexity of transitioning users to new authentication systems. So our core hypothesis with Socks, the cat, was to add a touch of whimsy. And the idea was to make the whole experience of authentication warm and fun, and even familiar and friendly. And familiarity is something that Cord is going to touch on later. It's a very important principle that we learned from this. And we really wanted Socks to convey helpful hints to users to help guide them through the experience. So even if setbacks or there was hiccups or there was new things users weren't able to address or things weren't working out, Socks was a way to convey helpful hints. And Socks was really a vehicle to do these things. And the hints were really what were helping users or what we were trying to offer to users. And ultimately, Socks was never gonna go prime time. Socks was really an experiment, a directional experiment, to help us find what resonated for users on Google.com. And really what Socks helped us discover was that Socks helped us reframe all of our thinking and our positioning to find a way to make authentication simple and transparent. And ultimately, that helped us learn that for our particular user base, convenience is absolutely king. Our particular users trust Google to help them make positive security choices. And also, it really helped us learn that introducing passkeys at relevant times is a really powerful tool. So introducing passkeys at authentication-relevant moments seems to have the best effect with our particular users. So during sign-in, account creation, account recovery, and reauthorization.
Like Mitch said, convenience is king for our Google users. So at every part of our passkey experience, we built it with a core of simplicity. What does that experience look like? It's a quick overview. So obviously, we've got sign-in. Users come in, and during authentication, we check to see if we think that passkeys are the right method for them. What kind of devices are they using? Are they using 2SV? Are they succeeding? If so, we go ahead and ask them right then and there to check out passkeys. If they think it looks cool, they hit continue. They get our super lovely WebAuthn modal, which is needed and managed by the platform, which in this case is sometimes us. And then we make it clear when they've succeeded. We've asked them to do something fundamentally new. The biggest thing about passkeys, I think, is that we are fundamentally changing the way that users experience their personalized accounts. For decades, we've been signing in with a username and a password. So this is a big change. We're changing the locks to the house. And we want to celebrate that for them, because this is going to make their lives easier. And then we let them in. Looks familiar. This is our sign-in. Obviously, we've recognized the user. We hit them with a personalized welcome. If not, they got to enter their username and their password. Once they go through that, if they have 2SV set up, they're going to see their next most secure challenge, whether that's SMS or device prompt, security key, TOTP. When they succeed, we try to make a first impression that's good and easy to understand. So we offer a straightforward and simple interface, aiming for an easy and uncomplicated first impression. In fact, we highlight that simplicity right in the forefront in that header, leading with convenience. We explored optimal messaging for introducing passkeys, experimenting with security, technology, and other features. And it turned out that what resonated for our users most was easy access to their accounts. So y'all might be surprised by this, but users are not online to authenticate. They are, in fact, online to get to whatever is behind that authentication. But change is daunting. Like I said, we're changing the locks. So how do we make it more familiar? How do we make it easier for them? How do we make it less scary? We create familiar associations. Mitch kind of touched on this. Passkeys are a technology that is incredibly secure, but behind a familiar experience. Users have been using fingerprint, face, screen lock for quite a while now. This isn't new. The user experience isn't new. The security is new. The benefit for all of us is new. So we say the word passkeys so people know what they're using, but we don't throw it up in the top area. We put it next to familiar words. With passkeys, you can now use your fingerprint, face, or screen lock to verify it's really you. That technology is super cool, but also super hard to explain. And you don't really have to at this juncture. On your UI, you can go into it a little bit, but really we suggest that what users need to know is what's going to happen, what's going to change, what is that new experience of signing in and getting to the experiences that they really want to be engaging with, past authentication. So they need to know more about, they're not putting in a password, they're just going to unlock their device. And those users who want to know more or need help figuring out how to create a passkey, they can and will find it. We put in a Learn More link that leads to our help center to help those users that need a hand. And we've also put out a ton of documentation, ourselves and with FIDO, to explain how the technology really works for all of us, most of the people in this room, who are going to go dive into the weeds to figure out exactly how it's functioning. All of those screens are really setting the user up for success when they get to this creation moment with the web authent modal. Mitch said that we're in a unique position. We are. We're an RP, but we're also a platform provider. So we were able to design this super streamlined Chrome WebAuthn modal. It's pretty clear. Create a passkey for Google.com. Create a passkey for whatever third party you've got right there. It's clean, it's clear, but it relies on the user is getting the preamble on the site that they're actually on prior to this. And hopefully, once they get here, they understand what's going to happen, and they're not scared to hit continue. Like I said, this is a big change. So letting them know that they're done is something you got to do too. So we do that for Google, for our Google account users. They've done something huge. But they're not really going to see it until they sign in again or they re-authenticate. So celebrate them. And we know that this is something that they really want. We tested it. They said, absolutely, please tell me. I did a good job. Fantastic.
And so something that we really wanted to achieve with passkeys was that through all of our different experiments and everything that we had learned, we knew that, of course, as Kort touched on, this was a brand new thing. We're changing the locks. We're changing the experience. So we really wanted to make sure that when users did learn something and they took the time to figure it out and succeed and we let them know that they succeeded, that they had learned something that they could bring forward with them. So we try to make sure that passkey creation and passkey sign-in feel familiar. So the first time you engage with a passkey, it's the last time you have to learn something about a passkey to get from A to B. It helps you, you've learned that skill for life. And so we try to bring that to WebAuthn as well. So we could bring that sensation of learning something and bringing it forward to everybody and anybody who wanted to use our platforms so that users wouldn't have to learn different things or new concepts effectively when you're trying to get through the front door. It's a passkey, you know what to do, and what to do is to solve your screen lock, whatever that may be.
Passkeys give the users the convenience that they want with the security that they deserve. But how is it performing? Y'all might have noticed that we launched. Right? So 64% of our users have found that passkeys are easier to use than their previous sign-in method, whatever that is, password, 2SV, authenticator. And 62% of users also feel more secure with passkeys than they did with their previous methods. This is pretty big. This is a critical thing that we found at Google. It's just as important that users feel secure as it is that they are secure. So we're really excited to see that most of our users are feeling that way. You might also be wondering, where are these stats coming from? Are these just from the early adopters, the security enthusiasts like ourselves in this room? We're definitely in there. But we want to make sure that this continues to be something good for everyone. We have a huge user base, and we want to continue to track that this is viable. So far, it's working well. As adoption is growing, we're continuing to ask these new users these questions, and we're finding that those users feel like passkeys are more secure and easier to use than their previous sign-in methods, maintaining that positive experience as our base gets bigger. More than that, though, 76% of users who have tried passkeys are likely to use them again in the future, meaning they find them so easy and fast to use, more secure, and they feel more secure that once they have adopted them, they're willing to use them again when they encounter them, perhaps on other sites.
Thank you so much, Court. And so what we really are trying to emphasize here are some of these key points. So what we really want to get across is that to help your users succeed, providing easy steps and super digestible guidance is something that really resonates well with users during authentication. As long as it's digestible, easy to understand, and they can comprehend what you're asking them to do in the moment so they can get through the front door of what they're actually trying to accomplish, that's super helpful, and that helps a lot. And simple and clear experiences. As we touched on, that transparency is something that we really value and we find really resonates well with users. When they understand what's going on during the flow, but not too deep, not too complex. It doesn't have to go overboard. But as long as the expectations are set, it can really help users get from A to B effectively. And one thing that we really, really believe in is that content strategy that's aligned with what makes your product valuable is really helping us make the difference from the UX perspective. And so SOX is part of what helped us learn that, but we did lots of experiments as we looked at in an earlier session. And really, another thing we want to bring is that there's lots of help out there for you too. So we really want to help users, we want to help our users, everybody's users, kind of get from A to B, but we know that a big part of that is providing the right guidance and documentation for everybody with passkeys. And so we have the incredible FIDO UX guidelines, which has been an awesome opportunity to work with the FIDO UX working group to create those. We're publishing guidance all the time. We have some guidelines at this URL from our Android team. We have the Google blog, where we're documenting some of our experiences in rolling out passkeys and some of our thoughts and some of our rationale on how we're accomplishing these things. And also, one thing that we really believe in as well is that it can be really effective to benchmark other passkey implementations. So you, as a user, can get a feeling of what you're being presented with as you go through these flows. Particularly if you go through them with like a fresh mind, a fresh set of eyes, it can really help you learn what's working well and what's not in different kinds of experiences. And of course, Court and I really believe in this last point as UXers, and that is to listen to your users, create that feedback loop, give them a way to reach out to you, give them a way to express their voices, and test and iterate. Because it's not always easy to get it right the first time, and giving yourself the runway to experiment and A-B test and come up with interesting ideas and find directional ways to kind of touch on what you think may work for your users can be a really helpful way to make passkeys happen in a way that's really effective. A big reason why we demonstrated SOX today, SOX was just one of many ways that we could introduce passkeys to users. It was one of many experiments, one of many focuses. But what we wanted to say was that for our users and for such a broad user base, we really wanted to find that directional focus that would help our users grok passkeys super fast and super easily. It was experiments like that that helped us achieve a messaging strategy and a UX that really resonated well with our user base. And so you can check out our experience at g.co/passkeys. We have an amazing team that's working really hard all the time to make this happen across google.com and our platforms. There's many, many people involved with this, and we're always iterating and doing new things to try and make it work better. And one thing we want to emphasize as well is that we never stop testing. We never stop keeping an eye on what's working and what isn't. And one thing we know from a UX perspective is that things can work for a while, and then they stop working because they're no longer effective for users. And also, we welcome everybody to engage with us during Passkey Week. And so please use the hashtag PassKeysWeek on any social media platform to engage with Google and others in experiencing passkeys. And it's a great opportunity to learn together about what we can accomplish for our users. And thank you so much. Thank you so much. And thank you to Court. Thank you so much, Court.
Thanks.
Awesome. So we do have a little bit of time for any Q&A that anybody might have, if that's something that we want to do. If anybody has any immediate questions. If not, love that. We explained everything perfectly. Everybody gets everything. There's no worries. Awesome. Everybody's going to roll out their own socks. Love that. Can't wait. Oh. Oh. We have one question.
We can.
Can you talk a little bit more about your experimentation and your testing? Like, what made you choose the groups of people to receive an experiment?
Absolutely, of course. So, as you can imagine, we do a lot of testing and a lot of experimentation. So what we do is, since we really believe in designing for everyone, and that's a very monumental task, what we do is we break things down into cohorts. So we'll break things down by the folks initially most likely to encounter passkeys based on our particular metrics. And so we'll break them down by country, age group, technical literacy, and then we'll try different messaging strategies to see how it resonates with them. And then we'll bring that to a further, to more groups and see how it resonates outward and see what's working and what isn't. Often, this is a process that can take some time and there is lots of people involved. Like Court and I work very hard on this, but we have amazing researchers, amazing visual designers. We have great leadership at Google who can help us find the right steps to take to help our users out. A lot of minds go into it and a lot of time and thought go into it. Does that help answer your question? Thank you.
I also think it's important to call out that when you're considering testing your experiences, especially with something so new like this, is to get your cross-functional partners all working together to determine what it is that you really want to press on. This is an exciting piece of tech, and a lot of people have a lot of opinions on how it might best sell, but you gotta find out what really matters, like Mitch was talking about. So we work really closely with our UXRs, but so do our product managers, so do our engineers, so do our TPMs. If they have a question, we try and see if there is a place for it in our testing to make sure that we're covering all of our bases for the multitude of personalities that engage with our products.
And I just want to build on that too. Our engineering team is absolutely spectacular and we love them very dearly. And so we encourage that communication at all times to try and create that back and forth so we can achieve the best product we can in a way that's effective for our users.
Strangely, the engineers did not like socks. I don't understand why. Yeah, that's right.
Be a good candidate for passkeys if you want to create a town. So I said, yeah. After today's session, sure, let's do it. And it didn't let me get through that creation process. It failed and it said, your device, you can't use passkeys on this device. And it was kind of late, but I don't really remember it giving me much detail around why. So I just figured that might be educational for everybody here that might be trying to do this. Is it because my device is managed by my organization?
Likely.
Okay. Yeah. We care a lot of as well with privacy in terms of web authentication.
Yeah, absolutely.
So there are different reasons why we might not always be able to convey the right error message. But it's often a case that management of a device can lock you out of that device's credential management services, which passkeys require.
For anyone who didn't hear that, someone in the audience tried to create a passkey last night after being prompted. But the device was managed by their corporation. And so it has to be enabled by their admin in order to do it. There are a couple of other reasons why a passkey may not work. Our engineers can probably speak to that a little bit better than I can. But we do have the different devices that are compatible listed in our Help Center article and other reasons why they might not be able to be created. But hopefully, we won't prompt when we know you're on a device that won't work. We can't necessarily know ahead of time if you're on a managed device.
Question.
What is your favorite metric when determining success for passkey?
Oh my god, okay, so our favorite metric when determining passkey, the success of passkey adoption?
Yep.
Amazing. Really good question. I think we collect both quantitative and qualitative metrics, and my personal favorite are qualitative.
I love when a user is going through a flow and we're interviewing them or they're doing a diary study and they're like, oh my God, I love this. This is so fast. I don't have to think about this. That's my favorite. But one of my other favorite metrics from a quantitative perspective is I really like to see end success rate. Love when that's a high number. If somebody comes out the other side of the flow and it's a lot of people coming out the other side of the flow, love that. Also speed. That's fantastic. Mm-hmm. If somebody's getting through quickly, like they're not even having to think about it and kind of digest and spend time learning and understanding, love that. That's fantastic.
Yeah, I love speed. It's great. Passkeys are actually twice as fast with the underlying technology, and we found that with our quantitative researcher, Sylvia Convento. We put out a blog around the time that we actually launched for Google Accounts, and you can go and see the graphs where we talk about speed. And we do believe that that dovetails really nicely into what we know our users care about, which is convenience and getting to that experience behind the authentication door. All right, well, we're not going anywhere. We're around for a couple more days, so find us if a question pops up. Cool. Thanks, y'all.
Amazing. Thank you so much, everyone.